So now let's take this pseudocode that we've written and let's convert it now to Java code. We figured out the logic of how the program should work or how we want it to work. And now we can actually put code to it. So I'm going to open up a new Java class, public class coinflip fun. Okay. And then public static void main string args. All right, so where do I begin? Well, there's a do loop, so I start with my do, right? Well, now that I'm getting into Java, I realize I'm probably going to need some different variables, and so let's try and decide which variables we'll need for this program. So we need to have some sort of input to get the user selection for heads or tails. The only thing is, we can have the user type in heads or tails. And that would be okay. It gives a little more room for them to mistype something. What I probably am going to do is instead of getting them to type heads or tails, I'm going to say press one for heads or two for tails. That's probably what I'm going to do in this program. That's kind of what I'm thinking. And that means that the input that I'm going to be getting, the pick for the user is going to be actually an integer. So maybe I create a variable called user pick, and I'll set that equal to 0 to begin with. And I can make little notes here on the side for my variables and say 0, or sorry, 1 for heads, 2 for tails. And that just helps me keep track of what's going to be sitting in that variable if it's not totally clear. Okay, so then let's see. I'm going to get the input, so that's okay. We're going to need a variable to hold what the flip was. So, and by the way, one of the reasons that I chose numbers for heads or tails rather than having the user type it in is because my random number that I'm going to get is going to be a number. We don't get random words, we get random numbers. And so what I'm probably going to do then is create a variable here that's an integer and call it I don't know what, flip result. I mean, whatever makes the most sense to you, that's what we want to use. And this will be the same thing, one for heads, two for tails. So I'll just maybe write that in there so I know that it's consistent. Okay, so then let's see what else we need. Well, I need a variable to keep track of the number of flips, so I'll create an integer called numFlips. And maybe it wouldn't be bad just write out the whole thing, number of flips. More and more, I think programming is heading the direction of being clearer to read, and so maybe that's clear, so maybe I'll do that. And then I don't know that I necessarily need a comment for that because it's pretty clear on what it holds. And then I'm going to need a variable for the number of wins. I already know that. I'll set that equal to 0. And is there anything else that I need? Well, I'm going to need this one to say whether they want to play again. So I'll create it, and then that's going to need to be text. And so I'll create a string and say play again, and I'll just set that equal to blank. Now again, these are integers, so we're going to put a 0 in. This one is a text, so we need to put a blank in, and then I'll just say this is going to hold a y or n. Just a little note to myself here in the comments. Okay, so now we can actually play the game for, well, how can we say it? While the user continues to say yes. Okay. All right, so now we can get into our actual code. And by the way, this is, I'm realizing now I probably ought to be, thinking about this a little bit more and spending a little more time. This is kind of off the cuff, and so this may not be perfect. Keep that in mind. This is one way of writing it, and if I went back and thought about it more went through the code again, I might change some things. But this is just a quick example to give you an idea. See, I'm getting all self-conscious now. But the truth is, there's not one way of writing a program. There's lots of different ways of doing it, and so this is one way. Okay, well, now I can actually get into my program. So I start out with the do, and then I kind of like to write the program. I put my opening brace for the do. I like to write the program kind of from the outside in. So I'm going to build this do before I actually do anything else on the inside of the do loop. So I'm going to create my do while loop, and again, we end that with a semicolon. That's kind of the one that's different than the other ones. We are saying that's the end of the do while loop. So keep doing this while that's true, but after it's not true, then that's the end. Okay, so what is the condition? Well, the condition is, do you want to continue, yes or no? And so I'm actually going to do that question kind of here at the bottom of the loop before I actually build anything above it, because again, I kind of like that style of working my way in. So I'm going to write out system.out.println and say play again. That was what I wanted to write, right? So play again y or n. Oops. That's going to be the question. Y or n. And then I'm going to read in that input. And where am I going to read it into? Well, I created this play again variable, so I'm going to say play again is equal to, and then I need to read in the input. Okay, well, I didn't think about that, but I am going to need to import the scanner to be able to read in some input. So I'm going to import the java.util dot asterisk. Well, sorry, the dot scanner. I could do dot asterisk, and that would bring in all the programs from the util class, but I can just do the scanner. And then I'm going to kind of come in above my variables. I like to kind of do this style and say scanner in equals new scanner system in. Okay, so I've got my scanner built, and now I can read in information. So I'm going to come back down to where I was and say, after I've asked them play again, yes or no, I'm going to read in their input. So in.next line. Well, I've got kind of a little dilemma here that I hadn't thought of. What if they enter something that isn't a valid input? And so I can go ahead and put in a little error checking here. And we've learned that we can do that kind of through a little while loop, but I can start out with an if statement, and maybe that makes more sense. So I say if the play again is not a y or an n. So the way we have to do that is say if it equals a y, but then we have to put a not out here on the front. So we're saying if it doesn't equal a y. And the tendency here might be to say an or it's not equal to an n. The problem with this logic is if it's a, let's say it is a y. Well, if it is a y, it's not an n. It can't be an n if it's a y. And because we have an or there, one or the other isn't true. And even though we have a y here, we don't have a y here, and so it'll go ahead and continue this loop. And so we have to say and. While it's not a y, and it's not an n. And then it's also the potential that they could type in a lowercase y or a lowercase n, so I probably ought to say equals ignore case on both of these conditions. Okay. And if it's not either of those, then I can say system.out.println invalid input, try again. Play again. Y or N. something like that, and then I can try reading in that input again by saying play again equals in dot next line. But then again, what if they enter bad input the second time? So they entered an X here. Well, that's not valid input. It prints out the message. And then we go to this line, and if it's bad again, then we need to instead put a while so that it will continually ask them to try again as long as what they entered was not a Y and it was not an N. All right, and then the good news is we can test this much of the program. Oh, we need to put in our conditional statement. So we want to continue to do this entire loop while what condition is true? Well, while the user typed a Y, right? We play again, yes. So we want to say while whatever's in play again dot equals ignore case a Y. So while they typed in a Y, we're going to keep playing. Okay? And then, like I said, the good news is we can test this out, this much of the program. So I'm going to save it. I probably should have saved it already, because if the computer just got turned off, the power went out, I would have lost everything. So it's a good idea to save early. And then we can compile and run this and see if it worked. Okay, well, this is good. I'm getting an error that says I was expecting a parenthesis. Well, I got one opening parenthesis there, another opening, and only one closing. So they're right. I need another closing parenthesis. Okay, so we'll compile and run this. Play again, yes. Play again, yes. Play again, X. Invalid input, try again. Play again, yes or no. Z, invalid input, try again. Play again, yes or no. And then as soon as I enter a no, then that should end the loop because that wasn't a Y, right? All right. I kind of want to put these things on different lines. I don't know why. You just start to get a feel for these things, but I didn't like the way it was kind of displaying there. So I'll just move that down to another line to just try and confuse you a little bit further. So I like to, we print the error message, but then we just ask him the question again, play again, yes or no. So then now if I run it, play again, yes or no, and I say X, invalid input, try again, play again, yes or no. So it's kind of going back to that same question again, or at least it looks like it. Okay, and as soon as I say N, then the program ends. All right, so what do we want to do next? Well, so we need to get the input from the user for their pick. All right, isn't that what our pseudocode said? So we go back up here and we're going to ask the user to pick heads or tails. So I'm going to come in here and print out system.out.println heads, pick, let's see, what should I say, enter one for heads or two for tails. Okay, and then I can read their input into the user pick variable. So user pick equals in dot next int is what I'm going to be reading in. And I can store that in the user pick variable. But then we need to do the same thing like we did down here and check to make sure that that's valid input. All right. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and stop here. And then we'll continue on with this program in the next video. Spencer out.